are people. These are stories of people who have delivered solutions that are homemade and localized, thereby changing the lives of women, debt-ridden farmers, and migrant workers.
And the nominees for Grassroots Soldiers are...
These are stories set in rural India of people who are striving at the grassroots level to make India a stronger nation. The nominees in this category are Chavi Rajawat, the Sarpanch of Sora village in Rajasthan, who chose her people over a comfortable city life. She is the force behind development in this hamlet. Kaushalendra Kumar, the brain behind Samriddhi, a unique business model that eliminates middlemen and improves the livelihoods of vegetable farmers in Bihar. Kishore Tiwari, the founder of Vidarbh Jan Andolan Samiti, an initiative that addresses the woes of cotton farmers and their families in Vidarbh. Malika Virdi, an avid mountaineer who established Mati, a women's collective in Munsiyari that strives to empower women and preserve the environment. Rajiv Khandelwal, he set up Ajivika Bureau in Udaipur, a charitable trust that gives seasonal migration workers a dignified life through skill training and financial and legal assistance.
He stepped into the world of political and social work almost 70 years ago in 1942, when he joined the RSS as a Swayamsevak. He entered Parliament 42 years ago in 1970 and today is among our most experienced parliamentarians, devoting his life to bring the BJP to the national political scene. Ladies and gentlemen, may I invite former Deputy Prime Minister Mr. L.K. Advani on stage.
In this category of grassroots soldiers, the winner is Sri Kaushalendra.
Congratulations, Kaushalendra.
Thank you. Pranam. I am not the right candidate for this award. If you ask me, the right candidate is all the farmers who are working with me and all the vegetable vendors who are selling those vegetables on roadsides. Gulab Chand Singh Yadav, Vinod Singh Yadav, there are many more. Ramlakhan Mahato, there are many more. They deserve this award.
मैं तो इतना ही कह सकता हूँ कि मैं इस प्रकार के सम्मान देने वाले कार्यक्रमों में कई बार गया हूँ लेकिन जिन जिन को सम्मान मिलता है प्रायः उनको कुछ न कुछ लोग जरूर जानते हैं पहले से बिल्कुल सेलिब्रिटी ही है ऐसा जरूरी नहीं कुछ लोग जरूर ऐसे आ जाते हैं कि जिनका परिचय बहुत कम लोगों से होता है लेकिन सबका किसी न किसी से होता है ये पहली बार है एक प्रकार से कि जिसमें अमेजिंग इंडियंस के नाम पर आम भारतीय जो हैं उनमें से चुन करके उन्होंने किसी ने अचीवमेंट किया हो जिसकी जानकारी लोगों को ना हो उसको टाइम्स नाउ ने देश के सामने प्रस्तुत करने की कोशिश की है इसीलिए यह कल्पना ही स्वयं में बहुत अद्भुत है और जिन जिन को सम्मानित किया गया है उनको मैं बहुत बहुत बधाई देता हूँ जिन्होंने इसकी कल्पना की है इस प्रकार के कार्यक्रम करने की और ये भी वचन दिया है कि हम हर साल करते रहेंगे और विश्वास करते हैं कि आम भारतीयों में से चुन करके जिन्होंने कुछ न कुछ अपने जीवन में अचीव किया होगा ग्रासरूट वर्कर के नाते इसीलिए ये कैटेगरी मैं समझता हूँ कि सबसे महत्वपूर्ण है और मैं इसलिए भी कौशलेंद्र जी को विशेष रूप से उनका सम्मान करता हूँ बहुत बहुत बधाई
दिस इज इंडीड अ वेरी वेरी स्पेशल अवार्ड फ्रॉम चूजिंग ऑफबीट करियर्स टू फाइटिंग फॉर वुमेन्स राइट्स दीज आर स्टोरीज ऑफ एक्स्ट्रॉर्डिनरी वुमेन ट्रूली एक्स्ट्रॉर्डिनरी वुमेन फ्रॉम ऑल वॉक्स ऑफ लाइफ हु हैव स्टूड अप एंड फॉट फॉर देयर बिलीव्स
And the nominees for Stree Shakti are...
We salute the women who have defied the odds and fought for their beliefs. The nominees in this category are Chetna Sinha, founder of Mandeshi Mahila Sahkari Bank, determined to liberate women in drought-prone area of Maswar in Maharashtra. Her microfinance bank has economically empowered more than 27,000 women so far. Hetal Dave, India's only woman sumo wrestler. Sponsorship is difficult to come by, but that does not dampen the spirits of this professional wrestler. Jagmati Sangwan, a women's rights activist. She is the only ray of hope for the suppressed under the authoritarian CARP regime that continues to kill innocent people. Ruchira Gupta, founder of Apne Aap. She is fighting to liberate women from the shackles of prostitution for the past 25 years. Shireen Juwale, founder of Palash. Recovering from her own trauma, she aims to give burn survivors a life of self-worth.
She made her political debut in the early 70s and became the president of the Indian Youth Congress thereafter. Behind her understated style is a woman of steel who manages the tightrope walk to maintain the balance between the freedom of the media and project the government's point of view in a very noisy democracy. May I call up on stage Information and Broadcasting Minister, Ms. Ambika Soni.
In the category Stree Shakti, it's Ruchira Gupta.
Namaste. I received this award on behalf of all the women and girls who are members of Apne Aap Women Worldwide, the organization that I founded to fight sex trafficking. They are victims and survivors of prostitution. Apne Aap Women Worldwide, along with organizing these women and girls at the grassroots to access their rights to education, livelihoods, safe and independent housing, and legal protection, is also calling upon all men to not be part of the demand. Today we have launched a campaign called Cool Men Don't Buy Sex. I ask all of you in the room to be part of the campaign to be cool men. Thank you.
I thank now and all of you for honoring so many amazing Indians. And I think these awards, if they were to increase, they would still never be enough. Because this is what's always going to help us try and strive for something more. I, for one, feel I'm not going to complain in my life as much as I have been complaining after meeting all of you.
Our next category in the Times Now Amazing Indian Awards is Urban Crusaders.
Working to make the city they live in model cities of the world are our Urban Crusaders. Nominees in this category are Anita Ahuja, the founder of Conserve India, an NGO in Delhi that gives ragpickers a dignified life. It trains them to recycle waste into functional products. Anjali Gupta, she is the driving force behind Buzurgon Ke Hamsafar, a free taxi service for senior citizens in the Delhi NCR region. Hamara Footpath, founded by Shubhangi Swaroop. It is an endeavor to provide street children a platform of fun and learning. Run by a group of young professionals, classes are held thrice a week on Mumbai's footpaths. Isaac Arul Selva, he started Slum Jagatu, a monthly magazine run by slum dwellers of Bangalore that highlights the hardships faced by this neglected community. Pratima Joshi. She set up Shelter Associates in Pune, striving to provide urban slum dwellers a better place to live in. She uses GIS to gather data and then advocate their cause with government authorities.
He's someone who has almost never lost a Lok Sabha election in his eighth term in the Lok Sabha now. He's juggled several portfolios in the cabinet with ease and brings his own style and panache to the job that he does. As Commerce Minister, he's even walked off from a WTO meeting to watch a World Cup football match to give time to the powerful Western countries to make up their minds about what India wants. Ladies and gentlemen, may I call up on stage Union Urban Development Minister, Mr. Kamal.
For urban crusaders, it is Hamara Footpath.
Is a community of people working with children living on the streets in Bombay. Education, informal education, medical aid and vocational training is what we do. The last 5 years have been an amazing journey for us, and the best part is that we're learning every day when we're with our children.
Thank you, Times Now, for the award. We strongly believe that it takes a community to effect tangible change in the lives of our kids. The children at HF are a great source of pride and joy for us, and we hope that we can continue to be an integral part of their lives.
I really am honored to participate in a program which honors those who deserve that honor. These are the Indians who are unnoticed, not visible, but represent the ethos of India. And these two young girls working in urban areas in ways which reflect their hearts and demonstrate their commitment and purpose. Of course, urbanization is a challenge. It's a huge challenge for us in India, and sometimes we tend to forget the street children, we tend to forget the neglected, and when we see those who work with those who are completely neglected, what more can be asked for? So congratulations to you both, congratulations to all the winners, and congratulations to Times Now for putting this together in a very unique way, because in honoring them, in recognizing them, in felicitating them, you not only felicitate and honor them, you felicitate and honor the ethos of India. Thank you very much.
And in the category Ordinary Indians, Extraordinary Stories, here are the nominees.
These are ordinary people you wouldn't look twice at on the street. But if spared a closer look, they have an extraordinary story to tell. The nominees in this category are C.K. Kumudini. This 80-year-old Alappi resident created history by winning a prolonged legal battle against a company for polluting groundwater in her area. Pauja Singh, an Indian-born British who has proven that age is just another number. This 100-year-old marathon runner is setting new records at an age that few can reach. Lakshman Rao. He is a tea seller from Delhi with a passion for writing. From plays to novels to political analysis, Lakshman Rao has penned 18 novels. Shachi Singh. She made Charbagh railway station in Lucknow child labour free. Her efforts have resulted in rescuing and rehabilitating more than 1500 children working in railway stations. V. Mani. He founded SoCare, an abode for children of convicts. He invested all his savings to give these shunned young ones a home, food, education, and a carefree life.
From being president of the Delhi University Students' Union in 1974 to being jailed during the emergency, he's juggled a legal and political career with ease and dexterity. He's been appreciated as India's law and commerce minister in the NDA years. In the last 2 years, his interventions in the Rajya Sabha have substantially raised the quality of our parliamentary debate. Ladies and gentlemen, may I now call upon stage Leader of the Opposition in Rajya Sabha, Mr. Arun Jaitley.
Ms. Sachi Singh.
Sabhi ko namaste. This recognition belongs to my entire team of Ehsaas and to all those people who stood with me and believed in my dream. My family, my friends, my husband, and the police people at the Lucknow station, the railway officials at the Lucknow station, and all those children who dared to dream and have changed their lives. I believe that because of today, maybe there will be a day that in my country, every railway station would have a protective environment and no child would be abused and exploited. Thank you so much. Thank you to Times Now. Jai Hind.
Well, thank you very much, Times Now, for your invitation to me to associate with this award function. I'm indeed privileged. It's really amazing stories of extraordinary Indians. We had earlier perceived that a sense of enterprise, a sense of determination really is in the field of commerce and business. But even in areas such as working for the society, you'll find an extraordinary category of Indians, some of them even marginal men and women, who are not in any way deterred by the adversity, but pick on an area and leave their footprints behind. And I think it's to the credit of Times Now that it has honored this extraordinary category of Indians, and I am indeed privileged to be a part of that celebration which you are doing today. Thank you.